Welcome to Hacks Be Shared. I have a present. It's an engineer's precision level. I saw it on eBay and I realised pretty quickly that it was Japanese, which to me means quality and precision. And there's a bit of a backstory here because for 2 years we lived in Tokyo, so I've got quite an interest in anything Japanese. I paid £60 delivered. You can see the precision marked on here. 0.02 millimetres per metre, which I think is equivalent to 0.2 thou per 10 inches. Also, there's a serial number. And you can see the make is RSK. So that's Riken Sokuhan Co. Limited. Niigata Riken Sokuhan Kaisha. And I thought there was a chance of being able to contact the company and find out how old it is. So we need to move to the PC now, and I'll show you what I got back. It can be difficult to search on a name where you don't have the Japanese characters, but I found this listing in English on a Chinese foreign trade forum. I located the company in Niigata in the northwest of Honshu, the main island of Japan. And as I suspected, it was a relatively small specialist company. You can see their offices here. Their name translates to Niigata Research Measurement Company. Their website seems to be only in Japanese, but I could see my level. There was a dimensioned diagram and instructions for setting the level in both Japanese and English. So I put an email together in Japanese and English. I can string a few kanji together, but this was beyond me. So I took quite a bit of the format from the internet. Anyway, I sent my email on a Sunday evening, and by the time I woke up on the Monday morning, a reply had arrived. It was from the managing director, Yutaka-san, and he told me that the level was about 30 years old. I thought it was amazing to get a reply like that. So here we are again, back in the shed. I've got the level on my surface plate. The surface plate is flat, but it's certainly not level. And I bought this level so that I can check if there's a twist on the bed of my lathe, meaning this or this. And to test that, I only need to test that both ends indicate the same on the level, but they don't have to be level relative to gravity and the centre of the earth. Now, the level has an adjustment screw on it here, and I can adjust that so that the lathe is truly level. And I can show you how to do that, but I don't need to do it for this particular job. To adjust the level to read truly level, all you need is a flat surface which is broadly level but doesn't have to be perfectly level. You would observe the position of the bubble. You would then reverse the level, take the reading from the other side, look at the error difference, and then you would keep adjusting until you got the same reading at the high side each time you reversed it. And when there was no difference between reversing it, you would know that you'd set it perfectly level. But we don't need to do that for this job, because all we're checking is the relative level of the two ends of the lathe. I've done a bit of work off camera already because it's quite fiddly to set this up. I've cleaned these flat ways and I'm using a couple of 12 millimeter parallels and this rule. And I'm putting the parallels in the center of the flat way. And I'm going to put the level on that. And I've been getting reasonably reliable readings. Anything really can affect this, I've discovered. Slightest bit of dirt, slightest different positioning in the parallels can have quite an effect. Now it's changed a little bit since I set it up. So I'm just going to have to move this bubble by raising this end of the tube. And that is probably enough. That tiny amount that I moved it there is bringing the bubble onto scale. So we need to let that settle. And there we are. I will bring the camera in so you can see it.
I should explain the reason why I've put that steel rule in there as packing. Because the level is so sensitive, the bubble is only in range on the scale where the level itself is almost level. And the Harrison manual says to have the lathe tilted forward and also down at the tailstock end so that this coolant will run into the sump. So that bit of packing there is to make those two parallels almost level, and then I can work within the range of the bubble with the adjustment, the bit of adjustment that there is.
You can see where the bubble is sitting, and I'll be looking to get the same reading at the other end of the bed. Now there is a bit of bed wear, I'm sure. I don't know quite how to allow for that. But if it's close to this, then I think that would indicate that it's not twisted, certainly not to any degree that I can measure. So having taken the reading, I need to transfer this setup to the other end of the bed, but not on the block, because we know that the bed block is a bit off anyway. So once again, I'll set the parallels in the centre of the flatware as best I can. And we'll let that settle. On the scale, there's short lines and long lines. And I don't know if you can remember, but at the tailstock end of the lathe, the level was indicating two divisions beyond the long line, which I've marked with that piece of plastic. And at this end, it's indicating about the same. Now, almost anything can put this out. A film of oil can put it out, certainly any dirt. But having settled it down, I'm happy that that is an accurate reading. So this would indicate to me that there is no twist that I can measure on the bed of this lathe. So having done that, we can also address another question, which is how reliable are the tops of these V-ways? Somebody did ask me, were they ground and scraped? Well, they're certainly ground. I don't think they're scraped. But I'm going to move this now to the tailstock end again, because the tops of the V-ways have not been molested as they have been in this area. And then we'll get an idea whether or not the tops of the V-ways are reliable relative to the flatways. Now, the distance between the centre of the flatways and the centre of the V-ways is about the same. So although I'm packing under the parallel with that rule on this side, because the distances are the same, I should get the same slope with the same packing. Okay, strictly I don't need those parallels in there, because they were only to get the level across the top of this V-way. But I've put them in so that everything is the same. I think you'll be surprised by the result. This tells me that the tops of those V-ways are extremely reliable as a reference and sit at, as near as I can tell, exactly the same angle as the flatways. I was just looking on the internet then. I want to show you a level that looks to me almost identical. Mitutoyo Can you see that? 364 pounds. And I reckon my level's every bit as good. So that's it. The lathe bed is not twisted. I mentioned that we used to live in Tokyo, and in fact I have another channel. It doesn't get many views. There's 24 videos, and each one is about as long as a coffee break, 5 or 6 minutes. About half the videos are just a family video that we took in 2001 and 2002 when we lived there. And the other videos are just a visit back in 2017 and another one in 2019. We took the children that live with us out in Tokyo, we took them back just to see what it was like. So if you're interested, I'll put a link in the description. It's not about engineering, it's just human interest stuff. I don't expect many views. It's there if you want to see it. Anyway, I hope that was useful to you. Thank you for watching. Hacks Be Shared.